Isn't there anything we can do about these high energy bills? Is there anything?
We've always been so careful. How could this happen?
We thought we bought an energy efficient house.
Everyone knows that a leaky house wastes energy, so finding and fixing leaks can save significant energy. This weather stripping reduces air leakage considerably, but not completely. Caulking around windows and floor molding can also stop air leaks. But the most important leaks are not so easy to find, those in your heating and cooling duct system. Duct leakage affects homes in many ways. Most obviously, it increases infiltration, which is air leaking into or out of the house. And because of increased infiltration, duct leakage reduces the efficiency of heating and cooling systems, wastes energy, and may reduce household comfort. Duct leakage also affects health and safety. Air pollutants may be drawn into the house from the garage, attic, soil, or combustion equipment by duct leaks. In a normally operating air conditioning system, room air is pulled into the return side of the system by the air handler fan and pushed into the supply side of the system. With no leaks, the duct system is a closed loop. Air coming out of the supply registers is the same that entered the return grills. Problems develop when the duct system is not airtight. A smoke stick helps find duct leaks. Even small holes result in a large amount of leakage. When a return leak occurs, outdoor air is pulled into the duct system, causing the house to have excess air. Like air being blown into a balloon, this creates high pressure in the house. House air is then forced out through all holes and penetrations in walls, floor, and ceiling. For each cubic foot of air coming in, a cubic foot of air must go out. Therefore, the amount of air leaving the house is the same as that being drawn into the return leak. When you have supply leaks, you lose twice. First, highly conditioned air is lost from your ducts to outdoors. This, in turn, causes the house to be starved for air, so the house experiences negative pressure. Outdoor air is then sucked into the house, and you lose a second time because this air must also be heated or cooled. The amount of air coming into the house is the same as that leaving the supply leak. Air conditioners move air across a cold evaporator coil to cool and dehumidify the air. When there are duct leaks, it is difficult for the air conditioner to do its job well. Return leaks draw hot summer air into the duct system. Because the temperature of the air entering the coil is raised, the final temperature coming out of the system is not as cold. As a result, the cooling capacity of the air conditioner is often reduced by 25%. The problem becomes more serious when the air entering the return leak comes from the attic, a common situation in Florida. Instead of outdoor air, the return leak pulls in attic air, which often reaches 120 degrees. The air entering the coil is now much hotter. So the cooling capacity of the air conditioner is reduced by more than 50%. The energy penalty of duct leakage depends on the temperature difference between the air leaving the house and the air entering. Supply leaks waste more energy than return leaks because the air lost from the supply ducts is colder than house air in the summer and hotter than house air in the winter. Supply leaks depressurize the house, causing outdoor air to be drawn in through all leaks in the house structure. In many cases, the big leaks are between the house and attic, so much of the air brought into the house by duct leaks is very hot. Similar problems occur in the winter. In the absence of duct leaks, room air is raised by about 22 degrees as it passes through a heat pump. When a return leak occurs, however, cold outdoor air is pulled into the duct system. This makes the heating system run longer and use more energy, leading sometimes to the complaint that the heat pump blows cold air. Without specialized training, it is often difficult to know if you have a duct leak problem. The symptoms of major duct leaks include high humidity, the heating and cooling system running excessively, a house that is too hot or cold, and high utility bills. For the building scientist, one of the big clues of duct leakage is high infiltration, a large air leakage rate of the house. Natural infiltration, that is air flowing into the house as a result of wind and temperature, changes about 25% of the house air each hour. When the central forced air system turns on, however, air infiltration increases by 2 or 3 times, indicating that duct leaks are pulling a lot of air into homes. The effects of duct leak infiltration are worse than we might imagine, for 2 reasons. First, duct leak infiltration only occurs when the air handler is operating, which is mostly when outdoor conditions are at their worst, on hot summer afternoons and cold winter mornings. Therefore, the temperature of the air brought into the house is hotter and colder than average outdoor air. Second, duct leaks often draw hot attic air into the house, so the impact on air conditioning is even greater. Let's see when duct leak infiltration occurs. Air conditioners run less at night and more on hot summer afternoons. Since duct leaks only occur when the air handler fan is blowing, duct leak infiltration is greatest when outdoor conditions are their worst. In the typical Florida home, air conditioning consumes about $2.40 of electricity per day if there are no duct leaks. However, duct leakage increases air conditioning electricity use to about $3.20 a day, a 33% increase. Fortunately, duct repair can substantially reduce this energy waste. Based on research in Florida, it has been found that duct air tightening can save $110 per year. Since the cost of such repair is in the range of $100 to $400, it can pay for itself in about 2 years. Duct repair can lower air conditioning electricity use during the utility's peak demand period, reducing the number of power plants needed. Therefore, many utilities are beginning duct repair programs. It is estimated that duct repair in 3 million Florida homes, at a cost of about $600 million, could eliminate the need for 5 large power plants costing about $2 billion. So the pressure is really on to find and fix leaks in your home's air conditioning and heating ducts. Leaks occur at seams and joints because tape adhesive dries out or was not installed correctly in the first place. In some cases, ducts separate or collapse, and the result is catastrophic leakage that overwhelms the heating or cooling system. At the end of the ducts, where supply boots meet the register, leaks are common. Most often, there is no seal between the boot and the ceiling sheetrock. This leakage can become worse when interior doors are closed, increasing room pressure, which backs up into the duct system. Leakage becomes dramatically worse if the supply register is closed, blocking airflow. The volume of air flowing out of the leak may become 10 times greater, overcoming any possible savings achieved by closing the vent. Leaks at the air handler occur at various penetrations. Cracks around access panels provide paths for air to enter or leave the air handler. Sometimes the filter access cover is left off, leaving a big opening. Even the smallest leaks near the air handler can be very serious because the system is under a great deal of pressure. When walls, soffits, chases, and spaces between floors are used as ducts, problems occur because these building cavities are not airtight. The biggest leaks happen when air handler support platforms are used as return plenums. A return plenum is basically a box from which the air handler pulls air. Return plenum leakage occurs primarily because adjacent walls are open to the inside of the plenum. Air is pulled into the duct system from those walls and any spaces connected to them. Once wall cavities are depressurized, air and pollutants can be drawn from anywhere, including the attic, crawl space, basement, garage, and outdoors. About 50% of all duct leaks in Florida are located in these support platforms. Significant duct leaks are found in a large portion of homes. In fact, there is an 80% chance that you need duct repair in your home. Finding duct leaks, however, requires specialized tools and diagnostic methods. The blower door, mounted in an exterior doorway, is used to measure the air tightness of the house. When the registers are sealed off and the blower door test is repeated, the size of the holes in the duct system can be computed. A smoke stick helps find duct leaks. When the house is pressurized by the blower door, if the smoke races into the register, there are large duct leaks nearby. If the smoke just sits in front of the grill, then there are no leaks. Measuring pressures is important to understanding indoor air quality because negative pressure can draw pollutants into the house from the soil, crawl space, and garage. Dangerous and toxic materials are stored in the garage because we don't want their fumes in the air we breathe. Duct leaks, however, can pull garage air into the system, so what is in the garage is also in the house. Even more importantly, negative pressure can cause flue gases from combustion equipment to flow into the house. A return leak in a utility room, for example, can cause combustion fumes from gas water heaters, furnaces, and other devices to be drawn into the system. When the air handler turns on, the room experiences negative pressure, which in turn can move flue gases into this room, into the duct system, and throughout the house. Because of this concern, a duct test includes measuring draft pressure and carbon monoxide, and checking for proper venting of combustion gases. Houses need to breathe because there are many sources of indoor air pollution. Radon from the soil, formaldehyde from building materials, pesticides, household cleaners, paints, solvents, volatile organic compounds, and mold and mildew. When duct leaks are repaired, house ventilation rates decrease dramatically, sometimes by a factor of 5 or more. As a result, indoor air quality may worsen. In a majority of new and existing homes, air exchange after repair falls below the industry minimum standard. 35% of the house air should change each hour. It may be necessary in some homes, therefore, to install a mechanical ventilation system to achieve good air quality. Once duct leaks have been identified and health and safety concerns have been resolved, duct repair may begin. Duct tape, however, is not suitable for duct repair because the surfaces are too dirty for good adhesion. Repair should be done with mastic and embedded fiberglass fabric. Once dry, this combination forms a rigid, long-lasting seal. Return plenums should be sealed from the inside by entering through the return grill or by removing one side of the support platform. The inside should have a continuous air barrier separating it from air in adjacent walls, the surrounding room, and outdoors. Various materials can be used to seal larger openings, but these should be resistant to smoke and fire development. Because repair is often done in small and closed spaces, it is important that repair materials be non-toxic. When leaks are difficult to reach, repair is most easily achieved by cutting open the duct and repairing from the inside. Several steps are required to achieve an airtight seal, including removing portions of the insulation from the foil. The fiberglass side of ductboard is not an air barrier, so sealing must be done on the foil surface. Final closure is made with fiberglass mesh and mastic. Mobile homes often have supply leaks, and fortunately most of these leaks can be accessed from inside the structure. Duct repair in many mobile homes can be done easily and inexpensively, and yet the energy savings can be very large indeed. Duct leakage in homes has turned out to be a much larger and more complex issue than we ever imagined. An invisible problem that, without our knowledge, has been robbing us of energy, a comfortable living environment, and safe and healthy homes. Nationwide, residential duct leaks may be siphoning off $3 billion per year in wasted energy bills and account for 10% of our electrical generation requirements. While the magnitude of the problem may be large, the opportunity for improvement is also great. At a typical cost of several hundred dollars, duct repair can significantly reduce your utility bills and may solve indoor air quality, moisture, and building degradation problems. And fortunately, many utilities are ready to assist you with the cost of duct repair, since air tightening duct systems helps avoid the cost of building new power plants. While duct repair is a great opportunity, health and safety must be the first priority. It is not just a matter of finding duct leaks and fixing them. We must look at how repair will affect house air quality and be sure that combustion safety problems, if any, are properly dealt with. Therefore, specialized training is essential to be sure that repairs are done right and that health and safety problems